This researcher is examining a 2D material under a microscope. You may have heard of 2D materials before. Graphene is one. It's made of a single crystalline layer of carbon atoms, or sometimes a few layers of atoms. Scientists are excited about a variety of 2D materials that are flexible and have electrical properties that make them attractive for display screens, wearable electronics, and energy storage devices. One 2D material that researchers, including this one, are particularly excited about is black phosphorus. This ultra-thin material is a semiconductor, and it has a high charge mobility, which means that electrons move through it quickly. The trouble with black phosphorus, though, is that it's tough to make large flakes of it. Black phosphorus also degrades quickly when exposed to air, making it difficult to study. So researchers at the University of Arkansas recently made an airtight sample cell and combined it with a fabrication technique called hot exfoliation. To make flakes of some of the newer 2D materials, researchers commonly peel them away from a larger block of material with adhesive tape, but this method often results in small or less than pristine flakes. Hot exfoliation, which involves heating a peeled material to help it bond to a substrate, can create larger flakes. The team separated flakes of black phosphorus using adhesive tape, then stuck the tape to a silicon chip. Heating the black phosphorus sandwich drives out gas bubbles, increasing the contact area between the sample and the chip. When the tape is pulled away after cooling, relatively large flakes of material remain behind on the silicon chip for studying. Now that the Arkansas researchers have their large flakes of black phosphorus, they can add them to the airtight cell they designed. The aluminum cell has a glass window through which researchers can image the sample. While working inside a glove box, researchers place a sample into the cell. Then they screw the two halves of the cell together, creating a seal that will maintain an inert environment even when removed from the glove box. With this combined method, the Arkansas group was able to get larger flakes and more of them, 6 to 10 times more material than usual, and they were able to image the flakes with optical microscopy and polarized Raman spectroscopy without the flakes degrading. UC Berkeley's Kwabena Bediako, who works with 2D materials, said he thinks the team's transfer cell is an innovative and simple design that will be helpful for working with air-sensitive 2D materials. Complete instructions for making and using the team's sealed transfer cell can be found in the Journal of Visualized Experiments.